there. This is Anthony Gray. Welcome to Grayscale. I'm going to do a painting that makes absolutely no sense. If you hear the occasional meow, that's because my cat is sitting here in the chair staring at me, wondering, what am I doing? I'm going to, well, first off, let me explain what you see. I have 11 by 15 watercolor paper. Surrounded by painter's tape and masking tape in various points across it. The paper itself is a mixture of black and gray gesso. I took some wrapper paper, plastic wrap, whatever. Crumpled it, placed it on here, let it dry, peeled it off. And those are the designs I believe that you can see a little bit of. But there's designs all through it and all that good stuff. The only thing I'm going to put on here is a moon, a mountain, remove the tape, and put a flower in the middle of it. Why? I have no idea. I just thought I'd do it just to do it. Okay? And that's about it. So let us move on. First off, I'll start with the mountain. Okay? Will more than likely be cutting it from the camera quite a bit. I'm going to first off coat with a thin layer of shampoo, which I'm using as a medium. Okay, I won't use the whole thing all over the place, but I want to coat more or less the bottom, so when I fade the bottom part of the mountain out, to make a nice little transition, as long as all of it doesn't dry, I should be able to fade it out. Alright, that's all I'm using this for. Like I said, if it tends to dry up on me like it's doing right now, because it's very warm in here, got the heater going, that's the sound you hear, then I'm gonna have to work kind of quickly. But if not, then I can adjust. But let's start off with the mountain first. Alright. I'm going to use, actually, black. I'm not a really big fan of using a lot of black, solid black. But just for this example, for this tutorial, I'll use black. And my lotion is evaporating as I'm talking to you because of the heat that's in here. If I wanted to, I could just put a little water in it, and it'd keep for a little while longer. Okay. So let's start with the peak. Something like that. I don't really care what's going on in the inside. Alright. That doesn't really concern me. What does concern me is down below, where I can get a nice fade. That's all. All that down there. And I just want to take it and fade it right into the lotion area as good as I can. Just kind of wanted to just disappear a little bit. Like I said, this stuff is might as well make a larger mountain. It's another peak here and go down. This stuff is drying up rather quickly. So I'm gonna take a little bit of the lotion here. It'll help with the fading. Thin up the paint a little bit. And then I can just get some of that dark and move it downward. A lot of this will be squirreled away, hidden by something like that. Some of this is going to be hidden away with the highlights anyway. But that's all I want to do. Alright, and then I'm going to work on my, do the highlights from there. The highlights for it, I'm going to use a little dab of white, with just the slightest touch of blue. Try to marble it a little bit. Now, I would prefer, really, to try to do this with a palette knife. Okay, and I'm going to do it with a flat brush. I guess I'll have the highlights coming from the right side. Just lightly trailing the color, let it break apart. Just like so. And some of it move downward. And just turn the brush around. Sort of like that, okay? And if it's still wet, you just take it and fade it on in there. That's all I'm doing. Mix a little bit of it in with the black foundation. I'm going to take some more, just mostly white, and I'll add minute little touches of highlight to it. A little more white than that. Because you want enough to of the white to gently glaze over your paint. It's going to touch the raised areas. Not really getting rid of everything. I'll turn the brush around. I got a little bit of light there. Some highlights. Just like that. Okay, I'm gonna clean the brush real quick. I'm gonna use, I got phthalo blue, it's pretty dark blue. Just a slight hint of white. Slightest. I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. You're gonna go in the other direction. To represent the shadow side of the mountain. And you can bring some of that into the light side, certain areas. As you can see, it only took me a few minutes just to make a convincing type of mountain. And you can make the mountain as large as you want. Have it go straight off the page or whatever. All up to you. But there it is. Alright. And if you take the tiniest bit of white in with that dark blue, you can add even a few highlights, backlight on that side of the mountain. But this is really your decision to do, or you can just keep it dark blue, really up to you. Draw right through the tape. Okay. If you would like. I'm just trying to find little spots to add here and there. All of it's going, like I say, in the opposite direction you laid the other colors down. something like that. Okay, and that's it for Mr. Mount. Now, it's time for the moon. You don't see it highlighted, obviously. The moon will take a slightly different approach. Okay, let me clean off this one brush that got the shampoo on it. Now, since the mountain is highlighted on the right, the moon will also be highlighted on the right. Okay. I'm going to take, this is a number 10 round brush. I am going to dip into the white and a little bit into the blue. Mix. A couple of little creative marks here and there. Sometimes I'll just create one. Well, maybe put a doodad in here somewhere. Just make up one. Rinse off the brush a little. I might even just tease a dark one in here somewhere. Maybe put one around here somewhere. It adds a little interest. Okay. Maybe a shadow. Pop a couple. It would be on the opposite side if it's lit. Alright. Just a little hint to you. Something like that. You can do all sorts of things to this guy if you wanted to. If you want. Okay. I think I want to put some trees around there with this guy. Just a few. I'll tease in a couple. I'll use my little fan brush. I'm going to dip into a little bit of this blue, pale blue, and a touch of the yellow. We got some lemon yellow here. A little bit on the dark green side. Okay, cross. Let's get some foreground here. Or foreground, but some grass here on the mountain, just a little bit. I'll just tap a few. Going along the path of the mountain here. If it appears too dark, I'll add a little more yellow and white to it for some simple highlights. Now I'm going to add some yellow and some white. You'll see what I'm talking about right now. And it'll be on the lit side, right around here. Add a couple. Some in here. A couple down here. thumb down, traveling down around here. Going in upward motion. Never try to make it flat, alright? Maybe even hint of a couple tall trees back here somewhere. Something like that. Some really bright ones here and there. Something like that. Look at that. Pretty slick, right? Pretty amazing what a couple of well-placed brush strokes would do for you. Once you get the technique, you pretty much do whatever you want. Basically, get the technique down first. See, right now I'm just piddling and playing around, but hopefully maybe somebody will pick up something and learn something just from me doing this. Alright. We have mountain, I don't know where, tree, or not tree, but the moon, out of nowhere. I guess I want to really maybe make it a sparkle, come alive a little bit, so maybe I'll throw some stars in there. I prefer the old beat up toothbrush. Alright, I'll dip the toothbrush in a little bit of the water and dip it a little into this white. I don't want to add too many stars. If you know how to guide this thing, you wouldn't have to worry about getting stars on the moon, stars on the mountain and stuff. Pretty experimental part for you if you're not sure about how to do it. Okay. I pretty much got, I've been doing it for a minute. I'll put some really on the corner here. Get some more of this white. Just dip the tiniest bit in water. Then you have to kind of drip the rest of it out in the water bucket there. You don't want it too crazy. And then I'll continue on here and there. Some up here by the moon. Maybe up in this corner somewhere. If you do get some, just wipe it away, it's alright. If it's on the mountain itself, wipe it away. Sometimes you want to be tough. Get some kind of close to the mountain here, maybe a bunch right here. On upward. A little Milky Way thing going on, maybe. Now, in case you get something like that, I'm glad that happened. See that little run? That's because the water's too, I got it too runny. But that's okay. It's already dry, so all you're doing is wiping it off like that. So don't panic. Wipe it off. Don't cry. Don't panic. Don't shout. Don't call 911. You're all right. Put a little more here and there. Maybe a few down here. Okay. Get some on the moon. Wipe it off. You're not gonna die. Wipe it off. It's all right. Alright, I think I did enough with the stars. That's enough of those. Alright. Just rinsing off the toothbrush pretty good. Okay. Yeah, that seems cool. Alright. Now, off comes the tape. I'll put some kind of ridiculous looking flower here, and I'm gonna snake off some strategically placed petals, leaves, and then that'll be that. Alright? So, slowly, the tape. I'm trying to see if I want to put anything else back here. Nah. And if I wanted to, and I forgot, it's too late now. I'll just take. Thinking if I should have put something else here. I'm thinking I should have, but it doesn't matter because I don't care now. Alright, and we're going to peel right off. And you can see the color changes when I take off the tape. Okay. Even though it's dark, all of this doesn't matter because I didn't put anything down here to begin with. But that's all right. I'll just save the idea for a later time. Maybe when I do a live video of it. Thinking that I should have put something on the bottom, but I don't remember now. Alright, anyway, that's what that looks like.
Alright.
I'm still thinking I cannot remember if I should have put something else there. I think I should have, this would have had more of an impact, but I don't know what I would have put there. But that's okay, because I got the patterns. I got this stuff streaking through it. Good enough. Alright. Enough second guessing. Let's move on. I have no idea what type of flower. It's okay. I'll create something. But anyway, it'll be somewhere around here. Something like that. The center of the thing will be here. Petals will be around here somewhere. As far as the leaves are concerned, I'll snake one off here. Alright. One will snake off around here. So one will be like in this direction here. One will be around here. Plop a nice size one right around here. Maybe a little one here. Something like that. And that'd be the end of that. Alright? Maybe some here. Who knows? And if I don't, I'll just take some water, wipe it off, it'll be good as gold. Don't matter. The flower's gonna be ridiculously bright. It'll probably be a yellow flower. Okay. Let's do the leaf thing. Leaves will be, foundational leaves will be pretty dark. I'm going to mix some blue and green together. Dip a little bit into Mr. Shampoo here. Put the medium right into the paint. I'm also using top grade paint too. I'm not using the student stuff. So it takes to the shampoo a lot better. Let's see, where can I be so I'm not in your way too much. Let's start here. Let's go in and down here like that. And we're just gonna scribble. Point like so. And let's put just the leaf in. Have a meet there, make one a little longer than the other one, a little shorter, something like that. Crazy little leaf. Something like that. Okay, that's one down. See, the professional grade paints take to the medium a lot better. Gives me a nice solid color. You don't have to be shy with using the medium. It takes a lot of it to thin it out. And even when you thin it out, it doesn't look all waxy and crazy looking. Alright. This do a little fella right in here. Right in here. Come to a point. And everything kind of zips kind of this way. Come like that. Okay. I'm dipping into this shampoo some more. This paint is extremely high quality. Pigments that stays in there. The medium is just, like I said, just to loosen up the paint. I think I might be in your way from these. Let me scoot over a little bit. See these little teeny tiny things. Whatever you want, you want to overlap, that's your decision. All right. I'm going to put them in there. And I'll make that the choice when I, quite frankly, when I get to it. Like that. Dip into a little more blue, a little more green, mix it up. Dip into the shampoo. Mix it in there. I'll probably use some of this for the highlight color for the petals. Some of the leaves. I said I'm going to put one right here, so I'm going to make a little vein. Like that. And we're going to do the same thing. A little squiggle, come to the point. Okay. Everything goes towards that dot. So, aim it toward the dot. Aim toward the dot. Toward the dot. Toward the dot. That's one dot. Do the same thing here. Aim toward the dot. Just like that. Okay. You know what? Just because, put one right in here. Straight off the cuff, just right here. We got one more, it's gonna come across the moon over there. I'm just getting some more medium. Let's get one. Snake around. Right on across and down. So it's coming right here. Okay? Right on across the moon. Just like that. There we go. All sorts of wild looking guys here. Now I'm going to mix some yellow and some white right into this dark green mix. Okay. A little more white. And here we go. Highlight on right side. Just like that. All this is nothing but controlling the stroke. This guy will be on this side, like so. Press and gently lift up. Press, gently lift up. Press, gently lift up. Like so. And let's do a little highlight. Put around the highlight and highlight that vein in the center. Like so. Do the same thing here. Highlight. And go straight downward, straight down, straight down, right here. Same thing with this guy here, straight down. Same thing here, and straight down, straight down. Right here. Okay, just dipping into a little more white. Highlight some of these guys down here. Just a little flick, we'll do it here. Nice little quick one, just like that. Don't always be so mega precise. Like that. Do another one here. Got that guy down here. Alright. Now as you see, some of the color starts to set in. It gets a little darker, so you might have to highlight some of the vein of the leaves a little bit. Not totally all of them, but especially this guy here. He comes up and around, he curves all sorts of crazy directions over there. Okay. I'm just adding a little more highlight color, a little more white into my yellow and white mix. We want it to stand out. Flatten the brush. And go for what you know. just like that. Now I'm gonna rinse off the brush real quick. I'm gonna add more white and the slightest touch of green, but I'm gonna keep it more white. It's got a greenish tint to it. I'm gonna highlight just certain leaves. A certain leaf. Not all of them. When I do it, I'm not going to go the same depth of strokes as I did the previous. Okay? Maybe just that one there. Maybe a slight highlight along the vein here, dipping in a little more white, and accent just a couple. Not many. This one here, accent. Maybe just a slight tip on those two, something like that. A little variation, you know.
Ruby Katie.
We're gonna do the same thing, same strokes on the other side, more blue. So I'm getting blue with a little touch of white. Okay. And I'll dip it, a little bit of that into the lotion. Shampoo mix. Not lotion, shampoo. Sorry. Okay, shadow side. Let's start with this guy. Just a slight twist and turn. Same thing here. And maybe a couple of them here. One linger right there. Flatten the brush out. Just like a plane taking off. Just like so. Alright? Almost there. Got this guy here. Something like that. A little more white. Even on these guys, got a little kind of a trail right there. And this one here, maybe a little baby trail. This one here, maybe toward the back. Toward the back on this one here, a little light there. A little more on these fellas here. A little closer to the moon. Let's make another one right there, just to do it. Something like that. Okay. I know we got one more sneaking over there. Let's give him one. Around that little two, that's too bright. Let's tone that down. Blue on that guy. There. Something like that. Okay? All of this will be flower and petals. Alright? Like I said, I want it to be mostly yellow. Some yellow-ish type of deal going on with that.
So,
I'm thinking of a nice color that would complement that dark when I put the yellow on. But first, let me get plenty of yellow because I'm sure going to need it. I'm going to need plenty of yellow, and with the yellow, I will mix white in with it. Make it stand out. Okay. But for right now, I still don't know particularly what the heck I'm going to do with it. I will just dab yellow with a slight touch of white in there. The white will help keep the yellow a little on the opaque side, okay? That's basically it. can see me doing here, it's going to be pretty much the stroke of the yellow I'm using is actually student grade yellow. Should be able to tell by the way it's waxing up a little bit. I'm not really a big fan of this student grade stuff, but I will make do with it. Right now I'm just blocking in the color. That's basically what you see right now, just that. Alright. Needs to be a little dark in there. Okay. I may want to probably put a little deep red, maybe. Some kind of deep reddish, reddish orangey type of thing going on. Some of the dark center there, which won't really be dark as the yellow flower. But I'm going to put a slightish touch of blue in this red. Kind of a weird, darky violet looking thing. Right in yonder area here. Do one of those and a little cup here. Alright, one of those numbers. No more, no less. It's gonna look like that. Alright? Just rinsing off the brush. Here's where it gets kind of interesting. Actually, before I really do anything with it, I might want to let that set and try it for a second. It does have lotion in it. So let me let it dry for a minute. Maybe nothing but a quick jump cut for you guys. But let me let this dry, and I can put shampoo on it, and then I'll call it a day. So, be right back. Okay, guys, let's finish this off. So. I'm going to mix in some yellow and some white. Mixing in white with the yellow because it will make it a wee bit more opaque. Alright. I might end up dipping in some more yellow. I got a feeling I'm not going to have enough. Just a hunch. We'll start with the outside petals. Alright. Everything's going to go towards its glob. Right around there. I think you guys should be able to see that. Okay. Okay, let's do this. I gotta get on the other side of you here. Alright, these petals are gonna be kind of weird because the bowl itself is kind of oblong. So we're gonna have petals. I might have one overlapping guy right here, and let's have one overlap. Come on around, around here somewhere. Definitely gonna have to dip into the lotion for this one. Shampoo, not lotion. I'll just write a blurb up there saying every time I say shampoo, lotion is just shampoo. Drop looking thing coming. Going invert toward that area. Alright. And here we go. Everything meets toward Mr. Dot. Okay. So, go a little bit past if you make a guideline for yourself. Go a little past that. Press down heavy disappear. Overlap the others. Okay? Just like that. Yeah, I'm gonna need some more. It's just in the cards. Alright, overlap this one guy. We're going around. Overlap. Do it again to the sham. Hmm. Give me some more. Most out of this color here. Okay. And we're going to do it again. Always remember where your line is, your vanishing point. Okay. Same thing with this guy. We're going to let these jokers go on the round. Alright. If it's a little too thin, you see the line, don't worry about it. Dip in a little more white, make it opaque. And you cover it on in. Cover it. Cover it. Cover it. Cover it. It looks like a highlight. So you're okay. Same thing with this guy here. Cover it. Just like that. Same thing with the guys. Right on out. Just like that. Okay? I got some paint too far up on the floor over there. I'm taking that out. Put it right on the tip. And we're gonna paint it off. I'm gonna end in there like that. We need some more white. And I'm gonna put this little cup area here. Find your brush, it might get a little muddy, a little dirty. Clean it off quickly. Clean it off. And while I'm doing that, I'm about to get some more yellow. I ran out. And surprise, surprise, I ran out of the bargain basement yellow. I gotta use this good stuff here, which is fine. This stuff is kind of thick. And it comes down like molasses, so give me a second. Ooh, I'm running out of this too. I don't have to really use too much of this stuff. It's really thick. Good stuff. Good color. Sorry about that. I might as well get a tad more white and run out of that too. Okie dokie. We're back in business. Just dipping into the yellow. This yellow is better green stuff. So. Dipping to the white, into the yellow. Okay, where were we? Oh yes. Let's do this. Let me give an S pattern. Like so. Do the same thing on this side. I was dirtying it up again. Hold on. Get an S pattern. Maybe on the outside. S pattern. And we're going to green. Kind of up and around. I'm gonna do it again. Now you have to think in layers, okay? Now I gotta bring another pattern. Curve it, curve it, curve it, right around here, curve, and go that way. Your vanishing point will be here. I have to use a little more white, maybe yellow. And we're gonna do it again. Like so. It's alright if you get a little bit of the red in there. It's alright. You're not gonna die. It's okay. hand off the 911 button, you'll be fine. Something like that. Okay. Now, if you cannot distinguish the pedals, a little trick. Do a slight push. Just like that. Now it breaks those pedals up a little bit. Alright? Same thing here. I'm going to give it a slight push. Same thing here if you can't see it. It's a tiny push. Okay. I get quite a build up on the frill, on the frill of the brush. I don't like that, but adapters. Just dipping in a little more white. Let's do a little bit up here. Overlap a little bit if you can. Push, bring it down and around, let it disappear a little bit. A little bit of a push, up and down, let it disappear a little bit. Something like that. This guy here, he's had him going to slip around like that. Make them all blind. Same thing here. I'm going to put a couple. Those guys in the center right there. And here, same thing. Just like that. Scoop all in there like that. I'm going to do the outside one here. I'm going to push, and push, and push, and push. And the surface line will go straight in that direction. Straight in that direction. Add a little more white. Have a nice push, and heavy push, and heavy. Okay. You know what? Let's have him push and heavy level. Yeah. Push, if you remember that, and then like that. Push, and it'll disappear. Like that. Okay. I might want to give a little tiny highlight here and there. Just a slight push on a couple of the pedals there. Push. Maybe here. Push. All right, I'll stop. Becomes too much of a mess. I'm getting a strip liner, nothing but pure white. And I'm going to play around with some of the edges. It's here on the outside here, where the moonlight would be hitting a few of them. That's all. Not every one. I'm just checking out, looking where. It doesn't have to be be everywhere. A couple of thin ones all around in here. A couple of twirls here and there. Just checking it out. Alright, whatever. Take a little bit of reddish maroon mix color, whatever. A little bit of blue, a little bit of red, mix it together. Some kind of weird looking soft, dark color. Like a softer black. Let's put the stain in and gotta wet it up a little bit, have it flow a little bit better than that. One there, got one coming around there, something like that. It's not wet enough. Outside the leaves here. Something like that. Just all over the place and coming down. Something like that. Let's see. I got an idea, so I'm going to take some of that out. I might as well do it. Messed up again, hold on. I'll get it right. My mind's in other places today. You have to bear with me, alright? I was right the first time. Yeah, my mind's somewhere else. Maybe. Bear with me, guys. I'm sorry. Alright. A little bit of green. I kind of like doing these anyway, so. Up around, come down, press. Ooh, it's not even bright enough. I have to mix a little red and white here on this one. That red is definitely not bright enough to do what I'm about to do. So I will do it over again. A little more white. Really brighten that red. Get back into the green. And we'll do it one more time. Yeah, that's better. We can see that, right? Dip into a little more white, into the red. Off a weird, funky red-green mix. And at this stage of the game, it doesn't matter. Get this green going. We'll put one dangling away, but a little bit below him. Come on, down, around the leaf, right around. Something like that. Rinsing off the brush. Get some more white. Some more red. Brighten that up a little bit. Get into the green. Now let's put one swinging out that rose, dangling in front of one, coming back around, straight down. Red's got to be a little deeper. Actually, the brush has got to be a little bigger. It's okay. We're almost at the end of this thing anyway. Have it come, look around. I didn't use enough green. Easily corrected. Still have the little stamens to add here and there. Rinsing off my highlighter. I'm going to need this towards the end because we're almost done. Okay. I don't see anything else where I would want to particularly add anything else. So I'm going to dip in to my pinky red mix in white. Add it in there, get it in white. Okay. And here we go.
Just put some nice little dots here and there.
I think it's a little brighter than that.
And a couple of little guys come out this way. Maybe come out here, here, somewhere, here, come out here, somewhere this way, somewhere here, this guy, and here. Got a few of them.
Something like that.
Okay.
I think that's about it. If this helped y'all, cool. Leave comments down below. Love to hear from you if you think it's good, bad, or indifferent. I'll add a paint a frame on this thing and wow, this is terrible. I'm gonna add the signature that ran out of white. We got a black background. That's bad for business. I'll cobble something together here. Once again, I might do this as a live tutorial. Time of me recording this, who the hell knows? Alright, anyway, name goes here. It's kind of sad, even though my name is sloppy on this one.
Might not be a good period for me to paint right.
It is what it is. Alrighty. There you go. Once again, thank you for watching this rather odd tutorial. I don't know what you're going to make of it. But it's done. I think I'll do this as a live project eventually. And give it a better representation of what this is. But I shall see you on the flip side. All right, take care.